Welcome. Today we are going to learn how we can use custom cursors in Visual Basic applications. So let us start with a practical demonstration that we have already created. It will demonstrate that how we can use load custom cursors in Visual Basic applications or C# applications. Here is the dynamic cursor loading application. The default cursor, as we can see here, is the white color with black border. Here we have show a list of cursors that can be dynamically loaded in this application. At which cursor we will click, the cursor of the screen will change of this application for this. If we go beyond this application, the cursor will be default because this setting is only for this Visual Basic application. We can see here the cursor is changing whenever we click on button with particular picture of the cursor. This is also called dynamic cursor loading application. Now on this onward, we will learn how we can create this dynamic loading application. So let us start creating dynamic cursor loading application. We are using here greenfish icon editor pro for cursor creation. We just have required any JPEG image can be downloaded from Google or any other media. So let's start without any hurdle. We are going to Google and trying to download some kind of cursors. We type here cursor, go to images. Here we can see a list of cursors. We have selected this one as in our demonstration. Now we are again selecting this one for the complete go through demonstration of the custom cursor creation or used in visual applications. Just save this image on the desktop with the name of cursors. Okay. Now the second step is go to greenfish icon editor. Just go to greenfish icon editor. As it opened, drag this image onto the greenfish icon editor. Now we are required to create a new graphic of dimension 64x64. This is the default dimension for the icon files. Now what we will have to do, select the cursor that we want to create the cursor file or icon file. Select this, press Ctrl+C to copy this cursor and go to the created icon file of dimension 64x64. Here we will press Ctrl+V for pasting the file. File is selection is pasted here. Just we are going to type Ctrl+T for transformation in the greenfish icon editor. We are giving here dimension 64x64. This is the complete selection of the file. We are just going to select this cursor, this one. Ctrl+C here, Ctrl+V, Ctrl+T, 64x64. We can clearly see that this cursor is settled and shrink according to the dimensions. Just press Ctrl+T to get rid of the selection. After this, we are going to use save as. Save as we are going to save is here in E drive. Let name it curve 1. Okay, save this. Okay, we does not select extension. We have to select extension here .ico curve 1. Okay, now we are going to select any other cursor. Let's say this one. We can select any number of cursors in the Visual Basic applications. Just press again repeated Ctrl+C. Here in 64x64 dimension, we have to Ctrl+V we. Just for the sake of integrity, we first of all clear it. Again, we are going here, press Ctrl plus C, here Ctrl plus V, and then again Ctrl plus T. We give here dimension of the cursor, press Enter. Ctrl plus D, again repeating the same operations, Ctrl plus C, Ctrl plus V, Ctrl plus T, giving dimensions, and then in the last Ctrl plus T to get rid of the selections. We are going here to file menu for saving this file. Do not choose save option. We have to say select here save as option. We let's say give its name cursor to CUR2 cursor to save this. We can see here two cursor or icon files are saved here successfully. Okay, now what we will have to do, we will have just to go for Visual Basic. We'll go to Visual Basic application, create a new Visual Basic application. Here we are going to, along with our demonstration, we are going to draw two buttons, removing its caption, and the second button also removing its caption too. Getting these buttons of same size as we have already discussed in our previous lectures, go to format, select both buttons and select both size. We are again selecting these both buttons. We have to change here style of these buttons just from standard to graphical for displaying pictures on these buttons. Select this button, select its picture property, go to the icon file where we have created. I think these are created in E. Let's say this is the curve 1. Again, for the second button, this is the curve 2. This is the process I have created only to create the visuals of the application as similar we have demonstrated in this lecture before. Okay. In code window, here we are using me dot. We can also refer to the form 1 dot mouse icon properties using load picture method of Visual Basic application. Here we will give the name of the file, icon file, that we are want to load whenever this button will click. Here I think is in E / cur 1 dot isav with extension. Okay, now run this project by pressing F5. By clicking on this, this is not working well. Why? Because we have to select this form as its custom icon. There is the major task we have to perform that I will forget. We have to select form. Here we have to choose mouse icon pointer. Mouse pointer property should be custom. Here we have to select mouse property, pointer property as custom. Now go again. This is working well. Because Visual Basic application already provided much more default pointer for our applications. We does not need any of these one, up arrow, down arrow, drop arrow, or beam, cross, icon size, etc. We have to select here mouse pointer as custom. Same methodology will be used for the second button. Copy this one, paste here, and just we have to change. Now we can see that this application is acting similar to our demonstrated application, changing dynamically cursor of the Visual Basic application. This same methodology can be used for any other languages such as VB.NET or C#. Subscribe our channel for more related videos. Thanks.